The nice thing about the Java Remote Object Model is that much of the heavy lifting that an application programmer has to do in building a client-server system using RPC, things like marshalling, unmarshalling, publishing the remote object on the network for the clients to access, they're all subsumed under the covers by the Java Distributed Object Runtime. And this is where one can see the similarity between the subcontract mechanism in the Spring system that we saw recently, which was the origin, in some sense, for the Java RMI. Before we dig deeper, let me give you, at a high level, the distributed object model of Java. The term remote object in the object model of Java refers to objects that are accessible from different address spaces, and the term remote interface is used in the distributed object model to say what are all the declarations for methods in a remote object. Once you have a remote object, the interface, remote interface, is saying what are all the declarations or for methods that are existing in the remote object that are accessible from clients anywhere. That's what remote interface is. And in the distributed object model of Java, the clients have to deal with RMI exception. So that's the failure semantics of the distributed object model, that the clients have to deal with exceptions that might happen when a remote method is invoked by a client. And there are some similarities and differences between local objects in Java and remote objects. The similarity is that you can pass object references as parameters when you make an object invocation. An object invocation arguments of that invocation could include object references. That's the similarity. But the difference is that the parameters, when it is passed as value result. That's the difference between local object and remote object. In the case of local object, when you pass an object reference as a parameter, then the method that is invoked can reach into that object that has been passed as a parameter, as a reference, and make modifications to it. And that modifications will get reflected in the original object. But in the distributed object model, because the object references are passed as value result, it's going across a network and is passed as value result, meaning the copy of that object is actually sent over to the invoked method, and that invoked method is seeing the copy of that object, and it is, even though there is a reference being given, but the reference is actually converted into value result in the parameter passing mechanism for the distributed object model. So that's a fundamental difference in parameter passing. So there's both similarities in the sense that you can pass object reference as a parameter, but the difference is the reference is passed in a value result mode as opposed to a pure reference. So in other words, once an object reference has been passed as a parameter to the server, if the client makes changes to that particular object whose reference has been given in the invoked method, those changes, the server will not see it because that is local to the client. That's fundamentally different between the local object model of Java and the distributed object model of Java.